Greetings, welcome. I'm Alonzo. This week's Torah reading initiates with the word in the Hebraic and the Hebrew re'eh, in the English behold. So let us behold. Let us take a closer look. Let us look at Isaiah chapter 54, verse 11. The prophets. The prophets indeed beheld. The prophets were able to visualize. Envision to see that which had not yet been made, or that had not yet came to pass. And so the prophets is very interesting because they beheld what I and I are coming to acknowledge. We are beginning to receive and sight and notice and distinguish and declare and testify and witness, and perceive that which was spoken of old by the prophets has come to pass, is passing as we speak, and shall continue to pass, come to being, to existence, shall continue manifesting until all is fulfilled. So that alone is interesting. So Isaiah gives us here a clear vision, a foreshadowing of that which is to come, so that when it come to pass, we may believe. But it's interesting how it's in context. It has a persuasive feel to it. So it begins with affliction. And that's the best time to capture or to to capitalize on an opportunity, business opportunity. In this case, Jah economics, which would be the economics of Beta Israel even, and the economy of Jah and his house, I and I being that house. But so this is Jah business. And this is how Geta Jesus, Lord Jesus, Ethiopiawi, the Ethiopian, in truth, the real Christ, Jesus, not Yehoshua HaMashiach, even, not the whitewashed Cesar Borgia, however it is pronounced. We destroy that, we ourselves shall become the wasters and destroyers of that, have we not? Yes, we have. I speak of truth when I make mention that we have made that quite clear, and we shall continue on doing so. But continuing, so affliction is a good time to kind of like sell that product, right? And then it goes on to make mention that the children shall learn. In our affliction, we hear the call. So first, we listen. We hear something that is good, and so we continue on. We forward on to take a look, because it sounded good. Sounds good. Let's take a look. So surely enough, commercials on. You walk in your room, and the angel of the Lord, angel of Geta, behold, look and see. Take a closer look. Step into I and I world. And step out of the world and take a, why don't you sight or come see a glimpse of reality. And so we begin to learn. Kedamawi, Chayle Shelasi, I and I father, Abba, Ab even. He shows us Jesus. So behold, look and see. Investigate, even consider, weigh your options, weigh them in the balance of righteousness. Now it continues on to kind of to make mention that which is persecuting you, oppression, fear, and terror. But then it is described how those shall have no effect upon the eye, and the eye, and I even, and I, and I, all the I them. So this is kind of like when the description of a product of why you need this product, you know, in times of affliction. See, you're going through this, you know, did you have a bad day? Because of this bad day, are you scared to confront your family? Are you terrified? Are you in terror of going to the doctor's appointment? Well, we got the solution for you, basically. You know, good advertisement. This is the context of this you know, portion of study is it's all persuasive, and that's interesting in itself. But yeah, let us continue. So now, behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his works, and I have created the waster to destroy. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. Yeta Yesus, you know? And so, at this point, you're kind of like, I want that. I want to buy that. I need that. But this is actually real. And not this, in fact, is not a deception. But, so let us proceed. Let us continue. So, now it's going to go into like, well, just, it gave us an idea, a glimpse of what we are to inherit. But now some of the, you know, the things that catch your attention, you know, like, most people do not agree with buying a product even because of the product. It's the keychain, you know. It's like, oh, but, and we're gonna get a key, you know. Okay, let you know, I got carried away. But yeah, you know, people are gonna buy a car and it's worth like, I don't know, I guess $40,000, $30,000, ridiculously a large amount of cash for nothing. Because, you know, really think about it. A chassis, suspension, engine, differentials, and a fiberglass body that won't last a couple years. I don't care how new the car is, you're talking about $5,000, you know, you're talking about $5,000 tops. And I don't know about cars and stuff like that, but it's pretty, okay, slave labor, they buy so much of these materials that they steal, first of all. And, you know, somewhere along the line, they probably use our own taxes to kind of like, to pay for this, I'm sure. I'm sure they've thought of a way, you know, and so basically, you know, $1,000 car people buy for $25,000, right? But it's not even the car that they're interested in; it's the keychain that they're gonna receive, right? Like with the car, or I don't know, the poster or something. That's how foolish I and I is. So now it's gonna go on to you know, to kind of like make everything glitter, make everything. To make this potential customer assure, you know, to clamp your yoke upon him. In this case, the yoke is light, right? But not out there, not in the hellish world. So everyone that thirsteth, come ye to the waters. And he that hath no money, come ye, buy and eat. Yea, come, but buy wine and milk without money and without price. I just thought of something. This is gonna turn off and turn away, cut off. This is gonna those words right there are gonna circumcise the flesh. And that is so interesting and sad. But you know, I have no pity on them, and I'm even thinking of my fleshy family, because they be like that. The minute they hear that no money is involved, I don't want that. It's useless. How am I gonna brag to everyone around me how much it cost me? I mean, that's basically the attitude that I see in this world. Not that I don't pay attention to it, but you know, let's not pretend that reality is not in fact reality. This is what goes on. The more, I mean, I know from personal experience that customers at times come, "I want the best thing you got." And one answers, "Well, it's the best is in reality, that which you decide is the best for you, you know?" And, "No, you don't understand. It's for this person, and I need the best." Well, you know, that one looks good, but whoever you're gonna give it to might not like it, so maybe he doesn't think that's the best. Okay, let me, and it's like they're like they notice that you're not picking that you're not like in tuned to their I guess a frequency that is barely on you know that barely carries enough life to speak. And so they lay it out straight, and look, I'm looking for the most expensive. And you let them know, like, well, that's not necessarily the best, you know. And so, but they'll never get it. So that right there, it just, I know I went off track, but it's just bringing to my remembrance how in this world, if you say that it's free, most people will not want it. At least not us that are ignorant, you know. Rich people that are wicked, they'll take anything free. I mean, but that's because I don't even want to go into that, you know, and we shouldn't. But anyways, so this is kind of like a catch. I'm thinking Jesus knows what's going on. Well, obviously he does, right? But so this is definitely like incorporated how Jesus like all he has to do to circumcise that flesh, which is not necessary, cut off that extra flesh, is say, you know, if you want water and stuff like and milk and wine, come buy it without money. So this is getting rid of all the world of the fleshy people, definitely. And that's I'm 100% sure of that. And so continuing, it says, "Wherefore do ye spend money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which satisfieth not? Hearken diligently to me, and eat ye that which is good, and let your soul delight itself in fatness." Man, so it's all kinds of you know, memories are coming to mind. Even that will discourage the world, because I've mentioned, like, you know what, like I've let's pretend I'm speaking to someone, and I'll be like, you know what, energy is free, you know, we could have electricity and all kinds of energies. Not only are they going to be like renewable and clean and non-destructive, and because they're not going to be of the combustion nature, which is this electricity that we use, which is the worst kind. It manifests from destruction. So how much more is it going to destroy and affect the environment? So combustion, you know, when you start the car, it's an explosion. But they need that in order for you to keep buying their gas, right? So I make mention. And we wouldn't have to work. We would have all day to learn, and you know, and I'm thinking like, studying and playing music and doing arts and crafts and stuff like that. That's what I'm thinking. And then they look at me with this face like, then why are we gonna work for? And I'm more like, well, we're gonna work just to live and be happy and you know, and eat and stuff like that. Not even that, because job provide for I and I. And then they're confused. It's like. Oh, then what do we work for? We want to work, you know. And so it's there when I notice how they love to be enslaved. You know, the world loves to work. It's like, that's what I work for. You're gonna spend money on that? You know, you really don't need that. You could just use that right there. No, but that's what I work for, cause so that I can buy stuff. You know, so I can. It's interesting, really. I've learned a lot from it. You know, from examining that kind of attitude. It's I don't know, it's just it's another world, we could say. So continuing, incline your ear, listen, you know, And come to me here, and your soul shall live. And I will make an everlasting covenant with you, even the sure mercies of David. Behold, I have given him for a witness to the people, a leader and commander to the people. Behold, thou shalt call a nation that thou knowest not, and the nations that knew thee. Oh, my bad. Let I go forward to verse 5. Behold, look and see. Behold, thou shalt call a nation that thou knowest not, and nations that knew not thee shall run to thee, because of Geta Adonai thy God, Igaziapir, and for the Holy One of Israel, for he hath glorified thee. This is kind of like it sounded good. Behold, look and see. And so you saw foreshadowing, you saw the commercial, and now you actually beheld, you revealed, it became revealed, and you know, now the revelation, you decide to act on the knowledge of that which was presented to you. So now you step out of your house, you know, hop on your vehicle and go to the dealership and look at the car, right? But now it's like step into the office. And before that, it's like, listen, this and that. Hear me out. This is going to be a great deal. You're not going to thirst no more. You're never going to be hungry. You know, my yoke is light. Who can resist an invitation so full of compassion? And this is where I and I, like, we seal the deal. We make that covenant. We sign off our names into the book of lives. Yes, we shall obey. And thus receive a blessing, or we don't get the curse like right away. The curse is if we fail to fulfill our end of the bargain. And so that would be like the last step, the fulfilling, the obtaining. Okay, here's your car. here, and so like now you received, now you fulfilled, you filled, you received. I guess I said that already, but you take on, you know. So let us continue. Oh, and the fact that it mentions that those that knew you, the nation that thou knowest that, wait, behold, thou shalt call a nation that knowest not, and the nation that knew not thee shall run to thee, because of the Lord thy God, and for the Holy One of Israel. I kind of lost that thought, but it has to do with the New Testament, how the, you know, the people in the crowd, they tell Jesus, like, how be it, we know whence he comest, and whence he's from, but Christ, no one knoweth where he comest and where he is from, you know? Kind of like that. We'll go into it. As a matter of fact, let us reveal that which was concealed in the Old Testament, but was foreshadowed. Well, not foreshadowed. Foreshadowed in the Old Testament, concealed, and then shown a glimpse of, like, give where the vision of that which was going to come to pass in the distant future. It would be the prophets, you know. So the concealing Old Testament. The glimpse, the behold, the take a look, and now the revelation, the examining, the proving, the testing, the kind of like the investigation, even the detective work, the showing I and I selves proved, the weighing of balance. All right, let us judge this. He said that sounds good to me. It looks good. It sounds good. Research and evidence, you know, seems to point to the fact that it is good. It feels right. It's good, you know. Kedamawi Haile Selassie, he testified to the Son that he came in the Ethiopiawi flesh. Okay. You know, bear record that he's the Son of God, and that he's not speaking of himself. He's the best emperor in this world has ever known, and the universe will ever know. You know, you start weighing and balance. You start, that's God, you know, that's Jah Rastafari, you know, may his name be praised. And so that's, at least that's what I'm receiving from it. So let's go to the New Testament, the revelation of the, and that, in fact, is, John chapter 7. Let us go to John chapter 7. It starts with verse 37. But I wanted to make mention that right after the end of the portion in this week's Rastafari Sabbatical Study 47, the prophet section, the next verse is, "Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near." So, I mention that because the context of John before the, you know, of chapter 7 before the actual portion of this week's study is dealing with the same principle. And it even deals with the circumcision, you know? And it's interesting how Jesus makes known that. Okay, you guys, I did one work, alright? I did one thing, and you guys are tripping out, you know? You guys are going crazy because I did this one work. How be it that Moses, you know, Moses therefore gave you... Well, let us just read that. That's... Jesus answered and said to them, "I have done one work, and ye marvel. Moses therefore gave to you circumcision, not because it is of Moses, but of the fathers." You see, now even this is a clue. Moses is testifying to the fathers, alright? And this is key. "And ye on the Sabbath day circumcise a man." If a man on the Sabbath day receives circumcision, that the law of Moses should be broken, should not be broken. Are ye angry at me, because I have made a man every whit whole on the Sabbath day? You cut from that which a man has to keep the law, and you're angry because I made whole that which was lacking in a man on the Sabbath day. See the lunacy, the hypocrisy of these people. "Judge not according to the appearance, but judge righteous judgment." So, check it out. Some seek him, but some seek to kill him. So that in itself is interesting. But continuing, I'd like to make mention that how be it we know this man whence he is, but when Christ cometh, no man knoweth whence he is. Then cried Jesus in the temple as he taught, saying, this is the children listening, that are listening and paying attention. This is the children them being taught. "Ye both know me, and ye know whence I am, and I am not come of myself, but he that sent me is true, whom ye know not. But I know him, for I am from him, and he hath sent me." Then they sought to take him, but no man laid hands on him, because his hour was not yet come. And many of the people believed on him, and said, "When Christ cometh, will he do more miracles than these which this man hath done?" The Pharisees heard that the people murmured such things concerning him, and the Pharisees and the chief priests sent officers to take him. Then said Jesus to them, "Yet a little while am I with you, and then I go to him that sent me. Ye shall seek me, and shall not find me, and where I am, thither ye cannot come. So what manner of saying is this that he said? Ye shall seek me and shall not find me, and where I am, thither ye cannot come. The fathers spoke to Moses. Moses spoke and testified of the fathers. You know, these hypocrites know not even Moses, much less the fathers. Yet they do know him, but they don't know him. They don't know who sent him. They don't know that Moses is carrying out that which the fathers carried out. So, continuing with this, you know, judge righteous, forward to the coming of Christ. Ye both know me, and ye know whence I am. So they know Jesus Christos, and they know whence he is, where he cometh from. And I am not come of myself, but he that sent me is true, whom ye know not. They don't know the Father, you know? They know the Son, but they don't know the Father. and that is true. I and I Rastafari testify to that. But I know him, for I am from him, and he sent me. Who did the Father send? Was it not Jesus Christos? That's exactly, you know, who I and I received from the Father. No one else sent I and I to Jesus but the Father. But they know not the Father. And they sought to take him, but no one, you know, because, oh, and this is key too. They sought to take him, but no man laid hands on him because his hour was not yet come. Which reminds that this is one of the main points of this. You know, we've assumed that no one know the hour and the day and the moment, the minute, you know, the hour and the day that the Christ cometh, right? That's not true, in a sense, you know, at least what I've received. We don't know when he leaveth, you know? But when he leaveth is the dark day, I would say. In you know, as far as what I've been able to receive from this. Because it makes mention that no man laid hand on him because the hour was not yet come. Jesus had come, and Jesus is still here. So the hour is not reflecting the coming, but rather the going, the ascension, the passing on, passing forward, over even. And so that leads I to accept that the hour that no man knoweth is not in fact the coming. And so and people believed on him and said, when Christ cometh, see, they're with that idea that not accepting who the Christ is, will he do more miracles than these which this man hath done? This man, you know, not this Christ. Although, you know, Christ is a man, but, you know, not the Christ, the man, not, you know, they're not making that connection. Yet a little while I am with you, and then I go to him that sent me. Ye shall seek me, and shall not find me. For where I am, thither you cannot come. You see, Christ was in the world. The Son of God was in the world, and the world knew him not. So they knew when he came. They knew him. But they did not know the Father. They don't know the scriptures even. This is the word of the Father, right? And so, because Jesus does not come and speak of himself. That's another point that, you know, how be it that this man know it letters, not having learned, you know? Jesus speak it of not of his own words, but of the Father. So if they would have known the Father, they would have known him, and they would have known that it was him. But they didn't. So now Jesus leaves to the Father, and they shall seek him, and will not find him, because they did not, well, first of all, they didn't know what they were looking for, basically, but also they did not do diligence to seek him out. They just assumed, because someone said, surely no prophet cometh from Galilee. Oh, and what, I'm supposed to, you know, like, base my eternal life on that? Heck, I'm gonna go find out. It's like, you know, you wanna go to some store or something, and some, you know, some random guy, hollers out, oh no, it's closed, they close at 8. Well, honestly, I really need that, which I'm gonna go get, and notice how I said, gonna go get. I'm gonna go find out. You know, at least I'm gonna call or something, you know? So, but most people would just say, oh, it's closed, you know? They don't open on Mondays, and you don't go, and you know, you could even drive by, and people are walking in and out, but because, oh, no, it's closed on Mondays, because someone said, you have to, you know, I have to really seek it out. But even more interesting than that is that, you know, Jesus left, you know, they weren't able to receive him right then and there in the flesh, much less like without seeing him, you know. And so after he leaves, they're going to be the Christ, where is the Christ? They rejected the Christ. And this is further explicated in the concealed Old Testament. That's why this is revealed, because it's making known all of this. And there's so much more. I'm just going to continue, because there is so much more that we could even just focus on, not even getting into the reading. You know, so let us continue. In the last day, the great day of the feast, you know, I wonder what that is referencing. Jesus stood and cried, that great day of the feast, yes, if any man thirst, let him come to me and drink. This is, this is the prophets. It's like, how more clear could it be? And I'm not saying this because I would have received it. I'm not sure if I was there, but it's not to judge, you know, it's to learn from the mistake. I'm not judging those, because all my life, things are, you know, everything is in plain sight, but and still I did not know. So it's not to judge individuals, rather it's to lay the foundation of righteous judgment, you know, before we go on to blame anyone, we gotta seek it out, search, and before we assume that he is or he is not the Christ, go find out, you know, the answers are in Scripture, and deep inside ourselves, but first it's the Almighty Creator that is good. And so, continuing, he that believeth on me, as the Scripture hath said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this he spake of the Spirit, which they that believed on him should receive. For the Holy Spirit was not yet given, because Jesus was not yet glorified, not revealed. He had not yet appeared through the Father. So, you know, I give thanks that I kind of discussed the whole not judging, because it would not have been a righteous judgment. And so continuing, many of the people, therefore, when they heard this saying, said, of a truth, this is the prophet. Others said, this is the Christ. But some said, shall Christ come out of Galilee? Hath not the Scripture said that Christ cometh of the seed of David, and out of the town of Bethlehem, where David was? The seed of David. Okay, so the seed becomes germinated, and then And then it bears fruit. And then it is processed. And, you know, being that it's a grain, one can bake bread or make bread with it. But they don't know this. Bethlehem, the house of bread, the house of David is in fact the house of bread. You know, I don't know, it's not really clear right now, because I hadn't thought about that. But I gotta look into that, because something just, I don't know, I'm something is like kind of like pulsing to check that out. But you know, for obvious reasons, let us continue. No one asked, is he really from Galilee? No one asked, you know, no one even bothered to mention, hey Jesus, are you from Galilee? Is that true? Were you born in Galilee? First of all, I mean, what a shame, you know, what a shame. No one even dared to ask. And so, continuing, because Jesus, in fact, is of the seed of David, as is his majesty. And Jesus Christus was born in Bethlehem. So, you know, goes to show how trusting our people, you know. So continuing, so you know, the rulers asked for them to detain Jesus, but no one dared to lay a hand on him, because no one had ever spoken in this manner. Never man spake like this man. For some reason, it just comes to me like the whole bring to eye an ass which man hath never righted. I feel that is exactly the same, you know, revelation. But I don't know. I can't explain that. So, but this people who knoweth not the law are cursed. Is that true? Yeah, it sounds true. Unless one has been able to keep the law that is in I and thy hearts. Nah. You know, we did away with that fairly quick. So, yeah, I mean, the rulers don't know it the law either. So, and they don't know the mercies of David too, which is interesting. So, the mercies of David are a part of the inheritance. You know, it's what's in store for us. It's part of the covenant. So, you know, foolish are them that know this not. Nicodemus said to them, He that came to Jesus by night, being one of them. One of them. Which reminds me, the fact that, okay, never, that's totally off track. Continuing, doth our law judge any man before it hear him, and know not what he doeth? They answered and said to him, art thou also of Galilee? Search and look, for out of Galilee ariseth no prophet. And every man went to his own house. Well, it could have been that Jesus was not from Galilee. And in fact, that is true. But, you know, so, you know, really seek it out. You know, search. Do some real detective work. But what he said, what Nicodemus said was right on. Doth our law judge any man before it hear him and know what he doeth? no one asked yeses, you know. And plus, this week's Sabbath study actually, goes into that matter. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, whether they are of God. You see, try him. Try Jesus, you know, try his majesty even. Because many false prophets are gone out into the world. Hereby know ye the spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christus is come in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christus is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is the spirit of Antichrist, Antichristos, whereof ye have heard that it should come. And even now, already, is it in the world. Ye are of God, little children. See, the ones that paid attention. Ye are of God, little children. And have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than that is in the world, than he that is in the world. They are of the world, therefore speak they of the world. And the world heareth them. We are of God. He that knoweth God heareth us. He that is not of God heareth not us. Hereby know we, spirit of truth and the spirit of error. That's why everyone listened to them. Oh, no prophet come from Galilee. Let's go home. Because they're of the world. You know, they know it not and listen it not to that which Geta Jesus even had to say. Because the rulers over there, whom they feared, said that no prophet has been born in Galilee. Well, even that is an error in reasoning, because Jesus isn't necessarily a prophet. Jesus is the Son of God, you know. So even that. And if we go forward to the concealed, once concealed, which is, in fact, the book of Deuteronomy. It begins from chapter 11, verse 26. Behold, so blessings if ye obey the commandments, and curse if ye will not obey the commandments. So it's that, It's that deal, that working out, you know, and its value is wholly on our will to observe and keep it and honor it and give it meaning and content. But I'm gonna mention something. Verse 29, and it shall come to pass when the Lord thy God hath brought thee into the land whither thou goest to possess it, that thou shalt put the blessings upon Mount Gerizim, and the curse upon Mount Ebal. Are they not on the other side Jordan, by the way where the sun goeth down? This is where Iandigraph will really help. So now we can picture, aren't they on this side Jordan, where this side could be either side. But the fact that it mentions where the sun goeth down, so it's on the west side. So on the west of Jordan, where the sun goeth down, are Mount Ebal and Gerizim. And continuing, it reads, in the land of the Canaanites, which dwell in the champaign over against Gilgal, beside the plains of Moreh. So, for ye shall pass over Jordan to go in to possess the land which the Lord your God giveth you, and ye shall possess it and dwell therein, and ye shall observe to do all the statutes and judgments which I set before you this day. Now, so Moreh is the place of the arrows and the shooting of arrows, I believe. So that's in fact the house of God, and then next to it is I wanted to include that. Yeah, Moreh is shooter of arrows, the archer, and then Orbe is or champagne is to grow dark. Araba, desert, a town in the tribe of Benjamin. So see how you know, if you go forward to the chart, it's describing the land of the Canaanites, which is in the winter, where the sun goes down in the west. So it's this west of the Jordan River, and so I just mentioned that so that we can see how it helps to put everything in like give it like a geographical even kind of like texture. And so let us continue. Ye shall utterly destroy all the places wherein the nations which ye shall possess serve their gods, upon the high mountains and upon the hills and upon and under every green tree. And ye shall overthrow their altars and break their pillars and burn their groves with fire. And ye shall hew down the graven images of their gods and destroy the names of them out of that place. Ye shall not do to the Lord. Ye shall not do so to the Lord your God, but to the place which the Lord your God shall choose out of your tribes to put his name. There, even to his habitation, shall ye seek, and thy there thou shalt come. Wow, so much embedded in this. Let us begin by the destruction. I and I is Nibiru. I and I come to this. Well, in one way of interpretation, I and I is to be that Nibiru and that Death Star and destroy these space invaders. I just wanted to say that. But definitely to destroy the space invaders. You know, those that come to invade Jah's space. This is the dominion of Jah. I and I is given authority over the west, the east, the north, the south. You know, he tells Moses, get up on this mountain, on this high mountain. Look everywhere. You know, that is I and I possession. He didn't say that little area. The world is our possession, even from river to river, from the Ethiopic Ocean to the Ethiopic Ocean. Now, continuing, I made mention that because, did we not destroy their gods with that graph? Has Wendem Yadon not consistently and continually destroyed the image of the Antichrist? Has he not debunked and defamed the dreamers of dreams that lead the crowds of this world to go and serve other gods? Hath he not stoned? Hath he not been the first to stone those which raise false philosophies of his majesty? And then, you know, I and I is to back him up and fulfill the killing, the destruction of this individual. That is why in the New Testament it says, he that is free of sin, throw the first stone. So, judge righteously. And that's, you know, that's coming up. So, continuing, I and I is to destroy them. Have we not destroyed their zoology? Have we not reclaimed every space of Jah? And we shall continue to do so. So, you know, if we go forward to the book of John, chapter 7 even, we just remembered, you know, we just came out of Nehase. Or forgetfulness, and you know, we received Spirit of Truth, and John chapter 7, I go on to correct that, but it's not necessarily chapter 7, but okay, I made the mistake of, but anyways, it is in the New Testament revealed how Jesus Christos he initiates the overthrowing of the money exchangers and the tables in the temple of Jerusalem. It, you know, and he saith, you know, my father's house is to be a house of prayer, and you turn it into a den of thieves. And so, you know, that's reflective of I and I, that we are supposed to do this. You know, we're, you know, like I made mention, I and I is trying to seek fellowship with Mexico and get Spanish studies. But if I made mention that, because, you know, they had on a message, they let I know that they had tried to establish a congregation and that it was not successful. And I said, it is. Victory has already been declared. Everything is set in order. Everything's in its place, you know. Everything is ready. All that is lacking is for the pieces of the positions to put value, to put holy value and honor the position, the piece, to become the pieces and give those characters or those pieces in this game, to give them meaning and content and signification, you know. And so this is the revelation. It's we must take on our role and responsibility, and so, you know, but let us not be fanatics, you know. Let us not just walk into some some church and start, you know, throwing stuff all over the place, you know. But if all seem right, Geta did it, you know. But it's, you know, in its proper context, you know, when you are really in wrath because of what you're seeing, like that's messed up. I don't care if I get arrested. I'm gonna go put everyone in their places, you know. what, people gonna try to detain you for keeping the word of truth in a church? I even thought about how it would result. I meditated upon it, and I saw the police officers, and this is in Mexico, because I pictured it in Mexico, because I'm, you know, I've been on the search for a Spanish Bible that is compatible with the English King James version, because you know, Brother Yaron requested that it be so that the studies could be kind of like similar, and so I was thinking, what should I get one online? Because it turns out I found one that's gonna be our best option, and so I was thinking, should I go to Mexico and buy one? But I'm gonna get so mad if all I see is like nonsense, and if they try to BS me, and like I was thinking this, right? I'm not gonna be able to contain myself, but I will for Jah's sake, you know, because the sake of I and I, Abba, you know, to keep it disciplined. But then I was thinking, but if it really came down to like something that really you know, really struck me to be offensive to I and I, God and Father, I was like, what are the cops gonna say? Like, if in case the priest, even I even saw the face of the priest, you know, like with this look where we're not going to call the cops, we're not going to say anything, we're not even going to respond because what you're saying is true, but how dare you in the house of the Lord? That's what they're thinking. I bet you anything I could, well, we don't gamble, right? But I'm sure that's what's going to be, because they're so delusional that they're going to feel insulted that you're speaking the truth of Jah Rastafari in the house of Jah Rastafari, even Kedamawi Haile Selassie and Geta Chanai Jesus Christos, you know. So that's interesting. I just pictured the whole scenario, and I wouldn't behave that way, because you know, Ainda is not out to seek destruction, but we shall destroy that which needs to be destroyed, you know. And so, but let us not go seeking that is wrong, that which is wrong. Let us seek Jah, you know, and rightfully replace everything in proper place, if so be it that in the place where of the tribes that the Almighty has put his name, then we shall go on destroying with full destruction that which is, you know, unbearable to Jahazites. So let us continue. That's context, you know, breaking down the images and all of that. And it, but notice this verse right here. But to the place which the Lord, Geta Adonai, your God, shall choose out of all your tribes to put his name there, even to his habitation shall ye seek, and by there thou shalt come. Thou shalt receive. Come is another form of thou shalt fulfill, thou shalt receive, thou shalt get. Geta. If in the revelation of the New Testament, and if now people would read, they would know that, well, let's suppose that this individual be it from Galilee. Chapter 12 of the fifth book of Deuteronomy, verse 5 says, But to the place which the Lord your God shall choose out of all your tribes to put his name, there even to his habitation shall ye seek, and there thou shalt come. Even if it's Galilee, thou there I and thou shalt come. If they would have read, you know. So yeah, okay, a resident. Okay, I just wanted to say, mention something on chapter 13. If a prophet, a dreamer of dreams, this is so Martin Luther King. Forgive I'm not, you know, it's only truth. He did dream a dream, and his dream was not the vision of Jah Rastafari. He was a priest. He dressed nice, and he spoke like an intelligent man. He did everything that one that is awake would do. He rallied the people. He came up. He stirred the vibes, you know. And he didn't know His Majesty. That is, even if he was ignorant of it, that is to prove I and I. So he came dreaming dreams, but he leaded I and I to another god. That's not of God. That's not of Jah Rastafari. And so that's plain and simple. But what I didn't want to, that wasn't the main focus. The main focus was that these, you know, Jah is so kind and so charitable, so compassionate. His word is so full of compassion. Who can resist? His yoke is so light. Clearly, it's not the first time. But who else will tell you? If a dreamer of dream, you know, he speaks of a vision, and but he leadeth to another god which you have not known. God himself has sent him to prove you, to see if you love him with all your heart. It's really so beautiful how plain and simple the truth is. You know, it's like, hey, children, I'm gonna set traps for you. Dude, watch out. If people come wanting to divert you to another god, I sent him to try you. It's not fair to say that Jah didn't warn us and stuff like that. You know, it's not even fair to even think of that being an excuse. It really isn't. So, and this is actually the part where, you know, if we go to verse 9, but thou shalt surely kill him. Thine hand shall be first upon him to put him to death, and afterwards the hand of all the people, and thou shalt stone him with stones that he die. Because he hath sought to thrust thee away from thy Lord thy God, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. And all Israel shall hear and fear and shall do no more any such wickedness as this is among you. Yeah, we know Kedamawi Haile Selassie. Excuse that. So if we are led to anyone other than Jesus Christos, we're being tried. It's that simple. Okay. So, that being said, you know, let us pause right there. Let us, in fact, conclude right there. But, last note, which is very, very important. Chapter 16 deals with our new calendar, which we should be really thankful that we have acquired. But, I have to make mention that, everything is laid, everything has been declared since the beginning. We have to take it. We have to take it by force. Claim it, because it's ours. We can't wait for anything. Listen, we don't need money. Yeah, we do. We do need money, but it's not in the sense that, okay, we need to gather enough money for everyone's plane ticket to Ethiopia. That's not how it is. We need money to continue on doing that which we are doing. And to even do more than what we are doing. But this is the way the spirit works. You know, everything is set. All that is lacking are the pieces that put meaning and content into the covenant. You see, the life itself is the covenant. Are we gonna take it? Are we gonna grab it? You know, even take it away from whoever has it right now. Because it's ours. It's ours. You know, I have here in the notes, it's an unconditional ownership. It was promised to our fathers. Are we not going to obtain it as well? We got to just grab that. You know, we got to take it. We got to walk the walk. We got to destroy these images. We got to flip those money changers. You know, we got to every opportunity we have to speak it like it is, we have to do so. Because, you know, if one does not utter words, how can he be heard? And that in itself is the destruction, but that'll only quicken it, the destruction. And now that we're entering the piercing, the underground, the lower months, where the light isn't as bright, I need to have to shine even brighter. Because you see, it's August 25th, we're going into September, and then we're gonna go into eventually December and January and these and even October. This is, you know, this is the wicked, the low level frequency, like the parties for all the wicked people, them and the fornications and all of that. I gotta have to shine that light even brighter, cause to balance, to make that balance, cause even the light won't be as it's gonna rest, you know, it's gonna enter into the sun Sabbath, the S-U-N Sabbath. And so, yeah, that was kind of off track, but not really. Okay, so continuing, we gotta take it, we gotta do it, don't let us not worry how it's going to happen. It already happened. We just have to bring life to the characters that play a role in this motion picture. And as for I and I parts, we glory in the Bible. And so, know for sure, I speak of truth when I say that all it takes is for, just let us pray and let us study. Everything is going to work out just perfectly. Because, you know, one of these videos might spark the fuse, ignite the inner light of a potential faithful and true witness of Jah Rastafari and his Christ, and he may be the owner of an airlines. That's how simple it is, you know? That's how simple it is. Put the message out. Let's do what we got to do and speak the truth. And then, Jabo, you're already in the... And we're always in the perfect situation because we are the situation, you know? And we even go on to make the situation. So you may be breaking down some BS that's out there, and the owner of the airlines might be grabbing a burger right next to this argument, and he might pick up on that conversation and Shema, oh Israel, you know, who beeth thou which inviteth thou to rest to a place so full of compassion and Rastafari board, you know, get on board Zion train. It's that simple, you know. That's just an example of how easy and how you know, is the arm of the Lord cut too short? Can he not do all and more? You know, we gotta have more faith, and let's not even worry how the things are going to be done. Let us just know that they're going to be done. Let us visualize the visions of the prophets that did not see that which had been already manifested have come to pass, so that we know that whatever Jah say will come to pass. So let us just know that it shall come to pass. Trying to figure out, I've learned, and I'm going to still keep on learning and eventually act on the knowledge of it, by asking, but how are we going to get there? And how, it's pride. It's wanting to know more than we should even care to know. We have to know, all we have to know is that Jah said it's going to be done, it's going to be done. You know, because why do we want to know, like, how the sun was created? To boast and brag about it. What, honestly, like, how is that going to really help us? Just look at the world and the Gentiles, all that they've learned, it's worse. So, yeah, I give thanks, you know. I don't know if this is a long video, but I pray that it's not. I know time is short on everyone's schedules, but I give thanks once again. You know, I pray that this information has been helpful. One last note. Yeah. In chapter 11, I made the mistake of thinking that the Torah portion reading started from verse 23. But it was good. It was good, cause it turns out that let me read it. Then will the Lord drive out all these nations from before you, and ye shall possess greater nations and mightier than yourselves. Every place, every city, every town, every meh. Every mekwam, every town, every place, every city, whereon the soles of your feet shall tread, shall strive even, shall walk, shall be yours. The soul, not only the soul of our feet, but yes, the soul of our feet, right? But everywhere that we step upon this earth shall be ours. Everything that comes into, everything that our soul comes into contact with is ours. Let us take it. Let us receive it joyfully, you know? And we've kind of gone over that on the graph. You know, the darker months, that's ours for the taking. That's to be kept separate. Tuja, you know, but it's ours, you know, everywhere that we step on, that's ours. Let us declare it. This is our world. And you know, I've begun to notice that no shame in the game when I and I be speaking to even my fleshy brother, and I'd be mentioning, nah, man, it's because Africa's ours, you know. As a matter of fact, the world is ours, because the world and the universe and beyond is our majesties, you know, set up on high. And so And it's a great comfort to just know that it is, you know? I don't have to be there. I know it's ours. You know, it's them that are deceiving themselves to make believe that they are in possession of it. In fact, it's a gift, it's an inheritance. It's a unconditional ownership, but it's a conditional occupation. That's why we're not there right now, because the occupation is conditional. The condition is keeping and obeying the law, you know? But it's ours anyways. I mean, that's kind of like, it sounds funny, but in fact, you know, sadly it is, because we don't keep it the law, we're over here. But it's ours in reality. But beyond that, it's God's. You know, it's Jah Rastafari, so no man hath the right to accept. The only exception, I and I, as Rastafari, you know, true and faithful, or seeking that which is true and faithful, and filling all that lacks within I and I in the mercies of David, which is part of the inheritance. That's kind of like, for sure you're going to get this, because if you try with all your heart, you're still not going to make it. But part of the deal, part is the insurance, the mercies of David. It's like the car insurance. So, you know, just to give like an idea of what we're dealing, what kind of business deal we're dealing with, and it's the best. It's job business. So, heavy labor, rest. You know, pain and suffering, joy and happiness, and fellowship and love and all that. So, yeah, let us pause right there, because from the wilderness and Lebanon, from the river Euphrates, even to the uttermost sea shall your coast be. There shall no man be able to stand before you, for the Lord Adonai Geta, your Igazi Abhir, your Elohim, shall lay the fear of you and the dread of you upon all the land that ye shall tread upon, as he hath said to you. Shalom, Rastafari.